At this place in history, we're on Ricker Pond in the Groton State Forest, of course, with Executive Director of the Vermont Historical Society, Steve Perkins. What are we talking about today?
So we're exploring history right where it is, as we normally do on this show, but something that the general public can come to visit, because we're standing on a rail line, which is now a multi-use trail, in a state park with this beautiful pond that's open for everybody to see. So yeah, we're going to talk a bit about the history of what happened right here.
So where does the story begin then?
Right when the American Revolution ended, this area opened up for English settlement. And one of the first people to move into this area was a Captain Edmund Morse, and he built a sawmill. And this is back in the 1700s, right kind of where we're standing, here at the foot of Ricker Pond, which flows south to the Wells River. He ran that sawmill until he sold it to a man named Ricker, hence Ricker Pond, and you can see there's a Ricker Mill Road. That mill stayed in the same family until 1960.
So why here? I mean, I imagine it's just because it was so plentiful at the time.
Very plentiful, and I think the landscape around here is so so rough and so inaccessible for trains and automobiles and even horses with sleighs. So it stayed pretty rugged in this area. By the end of the 19th century, the Montpelier to Wells River Railroad went in. And that railroad connected through what's now Groton State Forest. There were no roads in here at all. And it allowed all of these small lumber operators to just explode. There are mills up and down this railroad. What's now the State Forest Road follows roughly the railroad, and along every body of water, Groton Pond, Ricker Pond, even up to Osmore, and on the hills above Kettle Pond, there were sawmills. And they pumped I don't know how many thousands of board feet of lumber out of this area onto those trains and away.
And what was the ultimate destination for that lumber, and what was it used for?
So the bulk of lumber from the United States, and of course it had been sawn into boards here, was delivered to the port of Burlington. And at one point, Burlington was one of the largest lumber ports in the entire world.
So we ended our timeline with this area pretty much being clear cut. That's not the case today. So what happened in between?
So, well, at the end of this kind of this lumbering craze, they ran out of wood. They didn't have anything to do, and this land was wide open. So the company started selling all the acreage they owned for timber to the state of Vermont. And this started about 1919, and over time the state of Vermont added about 26,000 acres to their holdings in this area. It's the second largest holding for the state of Vermont is here in the Groton State Forest. And then it's used for recreation, and obviously the timber has started to grow back.
People want to learn more about the history of this area. How can they do that?
So they can go to our website, vermonthistory.org, and we have a page called History Outside for everybody to get out this summer and visit Vermont. And there are all sorts of resources there, and one of them is a guide, a historical guide to the Groton State Forest at this place in history.